here. That's home. That's ice. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard, every human being you ever was, lived out their lives. The air we get is our joy and suffering. Thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines. Every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilization, every king and peasant, every young couple of love, every mother and father, hopeful child, inventor, explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species, lived there. Load of dust, suspended in a sun. The earth is a very small stage in a vast cosmos arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and emperors, so that in glory and triumph they can become the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Think of the endless pools visited by the inhabitants of one corner of this big space, on the scarcely distinguishable inhabitants of some other corner. How frequent their misunderstandings, how eager they are to kill one another, how fervent their hatred. Our posture, our imagined self-importance, the delusion that we have some privileged position in the universe, are challenged by this point of pain. Our planet is a lonely speck in the great envelope of the cosmos. In our spirit, in all this vastness, there is no hint that hope will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. The Earth, the only world known so far to harbor life. There is nowhere else, at least in the near future, to which our species can migrate. Visit? Yes. Settle. Not you. Like it or not. For the moment, the Earth is where we make our start. It has been said that astronomy is a humbling, character-building experience. There is perhaps no better demonstration of the folly of human conceits than this distant image. To me, it underscores our responsibility to deal more kindly with one another and to preserve and cherish the only hope we've ever known. here. That's us. On it. Everyone you love, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. The aggregates of joy and suffering. Thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines. Every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilizations. Every king and peasant, every young couple in love, every mother and father, hopeful child, inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there, on a boat of dust, suspended in a sense. The earth is a very small state, a vast cosmos arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and emperors, so that in glory and triumph become the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Think of the endless pools visited by the inhabitants of one corner of space, on the scarce reefs of immeasurable inhabitants of some other corner. How frequent their misunderstandings, how eager they are to kill one another, how fervent their hatred. Our postures, our imagined self-importance, the delusion that they have some privileged position in the universe, are challenged by this. In our obscurity, in all this vastness, there is no hint that hope will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. The Earth, the only world known so far to harbor life. There is nowhere else, at least in the near future, to which our species might visit.
Yes.
Settle.
Not.
Like it or not, for the moment, the Earth is where we make our start. It has been said that astronomy is a humbling, character-building experience. There is perhaps no better demonstration of the folly of human conceits than this distant image. To me, it underscores our responsibility to deal more kindly with one another and to preserve and cherish the only home we've ever known.
That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being you ever was, lived out their lives. The aggregates of our joy and suffering. Thousands of conflict religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines. Every hunter and forager, every hero and power, every creator and destroyer of civilization. Every king and peasant. Inventor, explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species, lived there, on a boat of dust, suspended in a sunset. The earth is a very small stage in a vast cosmic arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and empires, so that in glory and triumph we become the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Think of the endless pools visited by the inhabitants of one corner of this big space, on the scarcely distinguishable inhabitants of some other corner. How frequently their misunderstandings out here to kill one another. How further their hatred. Our postures. Our imagined self-importance. The delusion that we have some privileged position in the universe are challenged by this point of pale light. Our planet is a lonely speck in the great enveloping cosmic darkness. In our all this vastness, there is no hint that hope will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. The Earth, the only world known so far to harbor life. There is nowhere else, at least in the near future, to which our species can migrate. Is it? Yes. Settle. Not you. Like it or not, for the moment, Earth is where we make our stand. It has been said that astronomy is a humbling and character-building experiment. There is perhaps no better demonstration of the folly of human conceits than this distant image. To me, it underscores our responsibility to deal more kindly with one another and to preserve and cherish the pale dot. The only we've ever known. here. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. The aggregates are joy and suffering. Thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic. Every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilizations, every king and peasant, every young couple in love, every mother and father, hopeful child, inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species, lived there. Of dust, suspended in a sun. The earth is a very small space in a vast cosmos arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and emperors, so that in the glory and triumph from the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Think of the endless cruelties visited by the inhabitants of one corner of this pixels on the scarcely immeasurable of some other corner. How frequently their misunderstandings. How eager they are to kill one another. How fervent their hatred. Our postures. Our imagined self-importance. The delusion that we have some privileged position in the universe. Our planet is a lonely speck in the great enveloping cosmic dark. In our obscurity, in all this vastness, there is no hint that hope will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. The Earth is the only world known so far to harbor life. There is nowhere else, at least in the near future, to which our species might point. Visit? Yes. Settle.
Not you.
Like it or not, for the moment, the Earth is where we make our stand. It has been said that astronomy is a humbling and character building experience. There is perhaps no better demonstration